It's a classic party trick. Suck down a balloon and you'll sound like Daffy Duck every time.
I worked with a lot of wisecrackers, but you're despicable. Hocus pocus, splitty blam, razzmatazz and alakazam!
But helium isn't the only gas that changes the way you talk.
Okay, now talk.
Okay. Oh, it sounds like one of those voice recorder things.
Oh my gosh.
Hey. Yeah, right on. Oh man.
So what's going on here? Your voice is as unique as your fingerprint.
10 points if you get it through her stomach!
I have to respect anyone who doesn't admire me as a performer.
Oh my God.
Janice didn't inhale a balloon full of helium. That's just her normal voice. So let's take a look at how that's even possible. The sound of your voice starts in your voice box, or your larynx. It's a 2-inch piece of cartilage at the top of your throat. In the box are two stretchy strands of tissue, your vocal cords, which vibrate against each other at a specific frequency when you talk. Women generally have thinner, shorter, tighter vocal cords than men, so their vocal cords vibrate faster, which generates a higher pitched voice. That sound is called the fundamental frequency of your voice. On its own, it just sounds like a simple buzzing, but when it reaches your vocal tract, the sound waves start bouncing around. Those reflections interfere with each other, which creates a mix of other frequencies that you can detect with a spectrogram. So even though your voice starts out as one frequency, it ends up as a mix of multiple ones. And that's where helium comes into play. Helium is lighter than air, which means sound moves faster through helium than through air. Nearly 3 times faster, in fact. So the sound waves bounce around faster in your vocal tract, which amplifies the higher frequencies in your voice. It's sort of like how speeding up your voice makes it sound higher
and higher and higher and higher and higher and higher.
But hold on a sec. These people aren't inhaling helium. They're sucking down sulfur hexafluoride, which is 6 times heavier than air. So sound waves move slower through it, which amplifies the lower frequencies in your voice. But here's the fascinating thing. The pitch of your voice hasn't changed when you inhale either gas, because your vocal cords move at the same rate no matter what gas you're breathing. So your fundamental frequency stays, well, fundamental. Regardless of whether you want to sound like Daffy Duck,
I can't help it, I'm a greedy slob, it's my hobby, save me.
Or James Earl Jones.
That's good.
Luke, I am your father.
Keep in mind that inhaling anything but air can be a little dangerous, especially when the gas is denser than air, because it'll sink to the bottom of your lungs, and you may have to get it out like this. What questions do you have about the human body? Let us know in the comments, and thanks for watching.